Start, I can start. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'd. Brothers and sisters, I am pleased to be able to talk to you today for a few moments. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are in the best of health and the best of iman. Today I want to talk about a couple of themes that we find in Quran and we find in the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salat wa salam. You will find out, I want to just take a moment and talk about what's going on right now with this coronavirus. I know that it's upsetting for people. It's a very difficult time. I want to let you know that I've got some good news for you. You know, Allah always makes the comparison in the Quran, and the Prophet alayhi salat wa salam always make a comparison between the believers and the disbelievers. You don't find in our tradition talking against people, the color, the ethnicity, the nationality, all of that, it doesn't matter, because the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, said, "In Allah Ta'ala, la yanduru ila asamikum wa la ila suwarikum wa lakin yanduru ila kulubikum wa amalikum." Allah is not going to look at your forms, but he's going to look at your deeds and your hearts. This is the thing that we'd be concerned about. So we're not against people because they're immigrants, or because they're black, or because they're white, or because they're male, or because they're female, or because they're young, or because they're old, or the nationality. We have 7,800,000,000 people on the planet speaking about 7,000 different languages. All of that, that's not important. But the thing that is important is our faith. Someone once asked the question, how long will the building stand? Answer, how strong is the foundation? What we're talking about today is the foundation. This catastrophe that's the whole world is confronted with, people look at it differently. And the thing that I get from the Quran, the most important thing that we should have is iman, faith. You can't inherit it from your parents. You can't pay for it. You can't go to the store and get it. You can't rob nobody of their iman. You got to get it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is that firm belief. And Allah makes a comparison always in the Quran, and the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him. For instance, the Prophet said, "Ajibin li amru mu'min." Wondrous is the affair of the believer. Astonishing, it's strange, it's unique. And he says, "Inna amruhu kullahu lahu khayrin." His affair, all of it, every bit of it, is khayr. It's good. So you ask me, "Imam Siraj, how you doing?" "Good." "It's good." "Are you crazy? Don't you see what's going on?" "Yep." But I know what the Prophet said, peace and blessing be upon him, for the believer, all of it, his affair is good. If Allah gives him sara'u, some kind of good thing, a gift or whatever, he is shakara. He's grateful to Allah. He's thankful to Allah. And how many blessings have Allah given us? In ta'udu ni'matullah la tusuha. If you try to count the blessings of Allah, you can't do them. So blessings all day long. But if he has some kind of calamity, and we have one right now, we have it in our own bodies, we have it in the world. If that happens, sabra, he's patient, and that's good for him. And again, the Prophet is saying, "Laysa dhalika li ahadin illa mu'min." This is only for a believer. So this is trial. I don't want you to think that this is not a trial for the Muslim. No, it's a trial for sure. It's a trial. The Muslims who have contracted this disease, the Muslims who've lost their jobs, there are Muslims that are suffering from that. But there's a difference, and the main difference is our connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has got the attention of the entire world. Everybody all over, Allah's got the attention. The question is, what are we gonna do about it? Two things I want to say. Number one, I want you to understand my thesis is, wallahu ya'lamu wa antum la ta'lamun. Allah knows and you don't know. There's nothing that happens. It's impossible for anything to happen except Allah is aware about it, aware of it. Allah mentioned Quran, وَمَا تَسْكُتُوا مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. There is not a leaf that falls except Allah knows it. That's an extraordinary statement. So I did some research and found out that Yale University have said that there are about 3 trillion trees on this earth. 3 trillion trees. Some trees have as many as 400,000 leaves. And when you say that Allah knows every leaf, nothing happens except by the permission of Allah. So this virus, the coronavirus, may be like news for us. It's not news for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows it. And He knows His believers are suffering. But He knows also that this world is temporary. And the Prophet alayhi salat wa salam said, "Ad-dunya sijnun lil-mu'min wa jannatul kafir," that this world is a prison for the believers and a paradise for the disbelievers. So what are we going to do? If this were the only life, then I can understand people going crazy. Nothing is going to happen. I want to take a minute and talk about artwork. Oftentimes in an artist's work, in their work is embedded their philosophy of life. I'm going to give you a classical example. Most of you heard of Shakespeare. And and there's this piece that Shakespeare did called Macbeth. And see, sometimes you want to quote Macbeth, but Macbeth is a figure, but the real person, the philosopher, is William Shakespeare. And so Macbeth's wife just died. And then listen to what he said. But you got to remember, it is Shakespeare saying this. "Life's but a walking shadow, a poor play that struts and frets his hour upon the stage and is heard no more. It's a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing." What? Run that back again. Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. I would agree with Mr. Shakespeare and Mr. Macbeth if there's no life after death. This life doesn't make sense. Your grandmother, your grandfather, you love them, they die. Your mother and father, you love them, they die. Your husband, your wife, they die. Your children, they die. Your friends, they die. Your leaders, they die. This life don't make no sense if there's no hereafter. So part of our faith is to believe, number one, Allah is in charge. La hawla quwwata illa billah. There's no might, no power except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never think that Allah is not in charge. Not for 1 minute. I don't care what happens. You cannot, anything cannot happen, nothing can happen except the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number two, as the angel said, Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka anta 'alimun hakim. Glory be to you, O Allah. We have no knowledge except for what you have taught us. You are the knowing and the wise. Allah knows and He's wise. There's wisdom behind this. We may not understand the wisdom, but for sure there's wisdom. And the question is, are we going to benefit from all these things that has happened? Let me give you a couple other things Allah shows us through His Prophet. He shows comparisons, and let me give you one comparison. It is agreed that Moses, one of the greatest and smartest prophets, one of the 5 great prophets, Moses was smart. Someone asked him from Bani Israel, "Ya Musa, is there anyone on earth more knowledgeable than you?" He said, "No." And one narration said, "Who is the smartest person on earth?" He said, "Ana, me." And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonished Musa because he didn't attribute all knowledge to Allah. So Allah told Musa, He said, "My servant Kidra, he knows more than you. My servant Kidra, he knows more than you." Musa always wanted to get more knowledge. He said, "Show me, I want to meet him. I want to learn from him." And so he finds Al-Kidra and then they begin their journey. Let me tell you lesson number one that Musa learned. They were walking down the shore and there was a boat and there was a little bird on the edge of the boat and the bird dipped his beak in the water. And Kidra said, "Yeah, Musa, the example of my knowledge and your knowledge and all the knowledge of the universe compared to Allah is like that water in the beak of that bird compared to the ocean. So again, we see this, you know, as smart as Musa was, as smart as Al-Khidr was, their knowledge compared to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, you can't judge Allah. Wallahu ya'lamu antum la ta'lamun. Allah knows and you don't know. Now, what are we going to do? A couple of things. First of all, don't forget the brotherhood. The Prophet والسلام, said, "Man lam yarham la yurham." Whoever doesn't show mercy will not receive mercy. Remember, a lot of the Muslims are hurt. Other people are hurt too, but a lot of Muslims are hurt. And so I'm reminded of the hadith the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, said, "Ta'amu wahid yakfil thnaini." The food of one can suffice two. The food of two can suffice four. The food of four can suffice eight. So what we have to do is make sure that everybody eats. You know, everybody eat a little bit, call one another. We're not going to the masjid. We're not making Jum'uah prayer. We're not making congregational prayer. And it could be lonely. And there are a lot of our Muslims who may be having some difficulty. So alhamdulillah, we called our elders the other day, some of our older sisters, and asked them, "You need anything? You need us to go shopping for you?" So we're doing that. And I want you to always remember that we are in this together. In the hadhi ummatakum ummatan wahid wa ana rabbukum fa'budun. Allah says, "This ummah of yours is one ummah, and I am your Lord, so worship me." So finally, I come with this. You know, I mentioned ad-dunya sijnu mu'min, that this world is a prison for the believer. There are a lot of things we can't do as Muslims. We can't drink alcohol, we can't take drugs, we can't eat pork, we can't commit zina, we can't do those things. Alhamdulillah, we give that up for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because we're His slaves and we believe in Him. But people of this world, they can do whatever they want to do. I want to conclude with, I told you sometimes the philosophy of an artist is embedded in his work. Let me give you the opposite side, the positive side. Omar Khayyam, the Persian poet, he was trying to explain in his eloquent way the meaning of the Qadr of Allah. Because that's what we're dealing with right now. When you see, as a Muslim, they believe in the Qadr of Allah, the good of it and the bad of it. So whatever good we have is from Allah, and whatever evil we have, Allah allows it. So he put it this way, he tried to explain the Qadr. He said, "The moving finger writes, and having writ moves on, nor your piety nor wit can lure it back to cancel out half a line, nor your tears wash out a word of it." Eloquent way of expressing the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're in it. It's happening here. Take advantage of this time. And I would like to make a recommendation that all the doctors make. Everything is about diet and exercise. Everything is about diet and exercise. What you eat. You got to eat the right food. And for us, part of the right food, I don't only mean, you know, proteins and things like that and vitamins, but I also mean the Quran. What are you doing with all that free time? You ain't watching TV like you used to watch. You're not watching all the football games and the baseball games and the hockey and the soccer and all of that. What are you doing now? Read from the Quran, drink from the Quran, and from the prophetic traditions of the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him. Diet and exercise. What kind of exercise you doing? Maybe some of you right now, you know, I was in Dallas, Texas, and every time I go to Dallas, Texas, there's a highway that we take, and there's a restaurant. I'm going to tell you the name of that restaurant, and you're not going to believe me. You're going to think I'm making it up. The restaurant is called Shuckin' and Jivin'. Shuckin' and Jivin'. You know, when a person ain't taking care of their business, they say they're shuckin' and jivin'. Let's admit it. There's some Muslims over the years been shuckin' and jivin', faking their Islam, pretending to be Muslim. But now is a big test, whether you've been shucking or jiving. So the Prophet, alhamdulillah, gave us some good news. إِنَّمَا الْأَحْمَلُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ. Your deeds shall be judged by your last deeds. So even if you started today practicing, or non-Muslim is guided to Islam, alhamdulillah, Allah accepted. Your deeds shall be judged by your last deeds. Be careful. take advantage of this. What exercises? Making your salat. Just because you're not making the salat in the masjid don't mean that you're not making your salat at home. You make your salat. Number two, don't stop fasting. Those of you who fast on Mondays and Thursdays, alhamdulillah, you continue to fast. And the fast of David, every other day, fast, continue to fast. And the last one, you want to hear about some good exercise? Dhikra. The dhikra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah mentioned in Quran, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. If you remember me, and this is a time to remember Allah, He said, I remember you. So Allah is not forgetting us. This right now, He knows we're anxious. He knows. He knows that. But just call upon Him. قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord said, call upon me and I will answer. So brothers and sisters, remember Allah. Allah remember you. Read the Quran, read the Hadith, and just do all the ibadat and asking Allah to help us. May Allah bless you. Hope to see you soon. I can't wait to hug you. That is the brothers, inshallah. So may Allah bless you. Hope to talk to you soon. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.